In the old legend, the wise men finally boiled down the history of mortal affairs into the single phrase, "This too will pass." Confronted with a like challenge to distill the secret of sound investment into three words, we venture the motto, "Margin of safety." An investment operation is one which, upon thorough analysis, promises safety of principal and an adequate return. Operations not meeting these requirements are speculative. A favorable difference between price on the one hand and indicated or appraised value on the other. That difference is the safety margin. There has developed the general notion that the rate of return which the investor should aim for is more or less proportionate to the degree of risk he is ready to run. Our view is different. The rate of return sought should be dependent, rather, on the amount of intelligent effort the investor is willing and able to bring to bear on his task. Operations for profit should be based not on optimism, but on arithmetic. While enthusiasm may be necessary for great accomplishments elsewhere, on Wall Street it almost invariably leads to disaster. The margin of safety is always dependent on the price paid. It will be large at one price, small at some higher price, non-existent at some still higher price. To achieve satisfactory investment results is easier than most people realize. To achieve superior results is harder than it looks. Objective tests of managerial ability are few and far from scientific. The underlying principles of sound investment should not alter from decade to decade, but the application of these principles must be adapted to significant changes in the financial mechanisms and climate. Investment is most intelligent when it is most businesslike. You are neither right nor wrong because the crowd disagrees with you. You are right because your data and reasoning are right. Obvious prospects for physical growth in a business do not translate into obvious profits for investors. Individuals who cannot master their emotions are ill-suited to profit from the investment process. The price of a security is frequently an essential element, so that a stock may have investment merit at one price level, but not at another. Obviously, it requires strength of character in order to think and to act in opposite fashion from the crowd, and also patience to wait for opportunities that may be spaced years apart. The exploitation of special situations is a technical branch of investment which requires a somewhat unusual mentality and equipment. Probably only a small percentage of our enterprising investors are likely to engage in it. Everyone knows that speculative stock movements are carried too far in both directions, frequently in the general market, and at all times in at least some of the individual issues. Furthermore, a common stock may be undervalued because of lack of interest or unjustified popular prejudice. We can go further and assert that in an astonishingly large proportion of the trading in common stocks, those engaged therein don't appear to know, in polite terms, one part of their anatomy from another. Selling short a too popular and therefore overvalued issue is apt to be a test not only of one's courage and stamina, but also of the depth of one's pocketbook. The principle is sound. Its successful application is not impossible, but it is distinctly not an easy art to master. Basically, price fluctuations have only one significant meaning for the true investor. They provide him with an opportunity to buy wisely when prices fall sharply, and to sell wisely when they advance a great deal. At other times, he will do better if he forgets about the stock market and pays attention to his dividend returns and to the operating results of his companies. The true investor scarcely ever is forced to sell his shares, and at all other times he is free to disregard the current price quotation. He need pay attention to it and act upon it only to the extent that it suits his book and no more. Thus, the investor who permits himself to be stampeded or unduly worried by unjustified market declines in his holdings is perversely transforming his basic advantage into a basic disadvantage. No statement is more true and better applicable to Wall Street than the famous warning of Santayana, Those who do not remember the past are condemned to repeat it. Ovid summed up Phoebus Apollo's counsel in three words: Medius tutissimus ibis. You will go safest in the middle course. I think this principle holds good for investors and their security analyst advisors. In 1949, we could present a study of stock market fluctuations over the preceding 75 years, which supported a formula based on earnings and current interest rates for determining a level to buy the DJIA below its central or intrinsic value and to sell out above such value. It was an application of the governing maxim of the Rothschilds: buy cheap and sell dear. And it had the advantage of running directly counter to the ingrained and pernicious maxim of Wall Street that stocks should be bought because they have gone up and sold because they have gone down. Alas, after 1949, this formula no longer worked. We have had a like discomforting experience with our own central value method of determining indicated buying and selling levels of the Dow Jones Industrial Average. The moral seems to be that any approach to money-making in the stock market, which can be easily described and followed by a lot of people, is by its terms too simple and too easy to last. Spinoza's concluding remark applies to Wall Street as well as to philosophy: all things excellent are as difficult as they are rare. As the Aeneid says, through chances various, through all vicissitudes, we make our way. As Horace says, many shall be restored that now are fallen, and many shall fall that now are in honor.